Dear student, in today's lecture we start chapter number 5, oscillations. Now what is oscillatory motion? In previous standard, you already learned different types of the motion. Oscillatory motion means to and fro motion. The motion of object, simply we can consider a few examples. Motion of needle of sewing machine is oscillatory motion. Motion of bob of simple pendulum is oscillatory motion. Means many examples we can give. The weightage of this chapter oscillation is 7 mark with option. So this is very important chapter and high weightage chapter in your board exam point of view. Now let me start the first article from this chapter, and it is periodic motion. So what is periodic motion? Let I tell you simple examples of the periodic motion. Motion of needle of sewing machine is a periodic motion. Circular motion, uniform circular motion is also periodic motion. Or periodic means what? Basically, periodic means which is repeating. Day and night are periodic things. The motion which is repeating itself after equal interval of time, that motion is called as periodic motion. You can see here. Which repeat, the motion which repeat itself after definite interval of time is called as periodic motion. Many examples we can give here. A body performing periodic motion repeats the same set of motion again and again. For example, when a body is moving in a circular motion, then if it starts at A, then again after a particular interval, the body is coming at again A. So it is a periodic motion. Then second example is motion of bob of simple pendulum. So if I consider this is a bob of the simple pendulum. So when it oscillates, then it repeats itself after equal interval of time. So the motion of bob of simple pendulum is a periodic motion. Now, the interval of time required to complete one set of motion is called as period. Period means what? Time required to complete one oscillation or one set of motion is the period. Now uniform circular motion is an example of this periodic motion. Another type of motion is to and fro motion is a periodic motion. To and fro means what? Oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion is an example of periodic motion. The simplest oscillatory motion is periodic motion, in which every particle moves to and fro about its mean position. It's simple word. In simple word, you remember, oscillatory motion is a periodic, but all periodic motions are not oscillatory, that you remember. Now next article is equilibrium position. Now what is equilibrium position? So that we have to learn here. Now, if you see the diagram very carefully, so equilibrium position means you can see here. So this is the equilibrium position. So the position of this bob at B, at point B, is the equilibrium position. Equilibrium, or it is also called as mean position. Okay, it is a mean position, and these A and C are the extreme position of bob of simple pendulum. So oscillating bodies comes to rest at their equilibrium position. When bob is suspended from rigid support, it goes to extreme position and then again come to mean position. And this mean position is also called as equilibrium position. I hope you understood what is equilibrium position. after the equilibrium position, we have to learn a spring mass oscillator. The mass and spring system is useful model for a periodic system. Let me consider one example. So in that we are considering a mass and spring. You can see here the motion of this body. So to and fro motion. To means once to this side and after some time to that side. So this is the equilibrium position. You can see here this is the equilibrium position. This object is moving to and fro of the equilibrium position. Once towards right side, once towards left side. Now if you see here the two things, restoring force and the position or displacement basically. So displacement. Their direction you can see here. When this block is moving towards right, the displacement is in this direction. But that time, the spring develops some restoring force and which is in opposite direction. You can see here the restoring force that time is towards left side. So here these two arrows gives the direction of displacement and restoring force. So what you can observe by this diagram, you can observe that the displacement and restoring force are oppositely directed. They are oppositely directed. Take it. Now here you remember one thing. We already learned elasticity. So inside the spring, restoring force is developed. And that restoring force is because of the displacement of the block. And that restoring force depends on the displacement. Larger the displacement of the block, larger the restoring force develop in a spring. So we can write restoring force proportional to displacement. And they are oppositely directed, so we can put minus sign. And if you put the constant, so we get this equation, F is equal to minus Kx. Okay, you can see some more diagrams here. So this is the equilibrium position. So when it is in equilibrium position, no restoring force. So spring doesn't exert any restoring force on this block. But when we pull this block with some distance x towards right hand side, then inside the spring some restoring forces develop, which is in left hand side. So direction is opposite, and because of that restoring force this block pulled towards left hand side. And again when it is at this position, some again restoring forces develop, and because of that this block is pulled toward this side and the motion continues. So simple equation we get here. Restoring force directly proportional to displacement, both are oppositely directed. So minus sign. Or we can write the constant here, and the constant is K. So where K is called as force constant. Where K is called as force constant. Now this type of motion is called as linear simple harmonic motion. It is called as linear simple harmonic motion. Now let me define it. Now what is linear simple harmonic motion? So linear simple harmonic motion means the motion where F and X, they are proportional and they are in opposite direction also. That motion is what linear simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion is abbreviated as SHM. SHM. SHM means simple harmonic motion. Now pay attention here. Simple harmonic motion is a special type of oscillatory motion in which particle oscillate on straight line. Second thing, restoring force is always directed towards the mean position. Third one, magnitude of restoring force is proportional to displacement of the particles from mean position. So restoring force proportional to displacement. And it is directed towards the mean position. Restoring force is always towards the mean position. So here this relation we get F is proportional to minus X. So we can write F is equal to minus Kx. k is a constant, depends on elastic properties of the body, and that constant is called as force constant that we already discussed. I hope you understood this simple harmonic motion, because in this chapter repeatedly we are using the word simple harmonic motion. So simple harmonic motion means you must know. Now here the negative sign means that force and displacement are oppositely directed. That also we discussed. Now we have to learn a very important article, and it is differential equation of SHM. SHM means simple harmonic motion. And you note one thing here, simple harmonic motion may be classified into two types: linear simple harmonic motion and angular. Now here we are discussing linear simple harmonic motion. So differential equation of linear simple harmonic motion. Now we use same thing which we already know. So consider one body is performing linear simple harmonic motion. Then we can write F is equal to minus kx. We can write F is equal to minus kx. Then by Newton's second law, you know that Newton's second law of motion is F is equal to ma. So we have F is equal to ma. Now that F is equal to ma, we substitute in equation number one instead of F. So we get here minus kx is equal to ma. Minus kx is equal to ma. So this equation we get. Now here, acceleration we have to substitute. Now you know that velocity is dx by dt. And acceleration is what? Dv by dt. So here if we substitute this v, then we get d square x by dt square is the acceleration. Okay. So that acceleration value we have to substitute in this equation. After that, we get m d square x by dt square is equal to minus kx. Now, next step, we transfer this m to the right hand side. So we get d square x by dt square is equal to minus k by m into x. Now this minus k by m we can shift to this side. So we get this formula: d square x by dt square plus k by m into x is equal to 0. But here k by m we can substitute as a omega square. So you remember here omega is under root k by m. Now how we get this omega is equal to k by m, that is coming in the next article. But you remember here, so omega is root k by m, so omega square is k by m. So this we substitute in equation number 4. So we get, and we get expression here. And this is a differential equation of linear SHM. This is a differential equation of linear SHM. Consider differential equation of SHM. Just we already derived this equation, d square x by dt square plus omega square x is equal to 0. Now we transfer this omega square x to the right hand side. So it is minus omega square x. Now here d square x by dt square is acceleration. It is acceleration. So we can write formula of acceleration. So this term is acceleration. So acceleration is equal to omega square x. Now in this chapter you note one thing here. Don't use A for acceleration. Now let I write here acceleration, full word. Now this is the acceleration. I hope you understood what is the acceleration. Now after the acceleration, we have to learn velocity. But before that, let I tell you two cases of the acceleration. The first case is case 1, at mean position. At mean position. Now what is mean position? Now let I tell you simple example. When particle is oscillating to and fro, then The central, this equilibrium position is called as main position. And this is extreme position. This is extreme. End position means extreme. So two extreme positions are there. At mean, displacement is zero. Because we are measuring displacement of the particle from mean position. Now at extreme, two extreme positions are there. The right hand side is positive extreme position. And at that positive extreme position, displacement is plus A. And towards left hand side, it is a negative extreme position and the displacement is minus A. Now A is what? Small A is amplitude. Small A is amplitude. Or you can use capital A also. Small a, capital A. Generally, we can write it for amplitude. Okay. Now, at mean position, if I use small a for the amplitude, then at mean position, x is equal to 0. Then how much is the acceleration at mean position? Let me substitute x 0 in a formula of acceleration. So, we get acceleration is equal to 0. At mean position. Now the case number two. At extreme position, x is equal to plus minus a. Okay. So acceleration is equal to. Okay. I use here a positive value. Okay. Is plus minus indicate only the direction only towards which side? So x is equal to a. So here we get acceleration is equal to minus omega square a. So instead of x, I substitute here a. So we get this formula. Now you note one thing here. So acceleration at mean is zero and acceleration at extreme is minus omega square a. So here the simple conclusion is acceleration is maximum at extreme. So this acceleration at extreme is also called as maximum acceleration. So the formula for maximum acceleration is equal to minus omega square a. In a problem, if the question is asked, find out maximum acceleration, means you have to find out this omega square a or minus omega square. I hope you understood this acceleration part. Now the next part is velocity. Now velocity of SHM. Again we consider the same equation, differential equation. Now you know that d square x by dt square is equal to minus omega square x. Now here we split up this term. This term we separated d by dt multiplied by dx by dt. And this term is velocity. So we can write dv by dt is equal to minus omega square x. Now we can do some arrangement here. So here we multiplied by x and divided by x. So this dx get cancelled, we get this term again. dv by dt is minus omega square x. So that we done for the simplicity only. Okay. Now here, this dx we can shift to this side and this dv we can shift to this side. Means we get the next equation. Next equation we get no need to shift here because already we are written accordingly. So this dx by dt, it is what? Velocity. Okay, and this dv by dx as it is. So we get this term. V dv by dx is equal to minus omega square x. Now we transfer this dx to right hand side. So here it is divided to that side, it is multiplied. So we get the term v dv is equal to minus omega square x and this dx to this right hand side, it is multiplied. Now by using this formula, we have to obtain v, and v is the velocity in SHM. So how we obtain v? So let me integrate this equation. After integration, we get integration of v dv is equal to integration minus omega square h dx. But here this minus omega square is constant, so taken out. So integration x dx. So you know that integration x dx is how much? It is x square by 2. Integration v dv is equal to v square by 2. And plus constant of integration we can write. So here, this integration v dv, we have written v square by 2. Then integration x dx, we have written x square by 2. And the plus c, it is a constant of integration. It is constant of integration. Now, we have to find out this constant of integration. So at extreme position, what is extreme position? Just already I explained what is extreme position. So when particle is at extreme position, means at mean x is equal to 0. So at extreme, x is equal to a plus a, and to that side x is equal to minus a. Okay. When particle is following this to and fro motion, so at extreme, the velocity of the particle is 0. Because you know the simple example of the simple pendulum. So this is the mean position. When pendulum is oscillating, when it reaches to the extreme position, velocity decrease, here velocity is 0. Then it return back to the mean position. And again to move this side, and velocity decrease, when velocity is 0, it moves toward the equilibrium position. Means at extreme, the v is 0. In simple conclusion, you remember at extreme, means at x is equal to a, v is equal to 0. So here, this capital A is for amplitude. So here, x is equal to this side, minus a, and to this side, plus a. We can use small a, capital A for this amplitude. So v is 0. Hence, we substitute in this formula. So v is equal to 0, we have to substitute, and x is equal to a, we have to substitute in equation 1. Then what we get? So we get 0 square by 2, 0 is equal to minus omega square a square by 2 plus c. Now this term, we can shift to this side, left hand side. So we get a formula of c, and the c is given by this. C is equal to omega square a square by 2. And this c, we can substitute in equation number 1. So this is the value of c that we have to substitute in equation number 1. After substitution, what we get? This v square by 2 is equal to minus omega square x square by 2 as it is. Okay. Plus c. Instead of c, we have written this omega square a square by 2. Now, from this, we can take the common. So what we can take common? So we can take this 2 common. So 1 by 2 common from both the sides. Then this 2 get cancelled. Then we get v square is equal to, as well as from this right hand side, we are taken omega square common. So as we take omega square common, we get minus x square plus a square in a bracket. So only first we are written a square and then minus x square. So this is v square. Okay. And taking square root of the both side, we get a final formula of the velocity of this SHM. And it is plus minus omega in a root a square minus x square. This is expression for velocity of SHM. Now here, we have written the plus minus sign. The reason is plus omega having a square omega square, and minus omega also having a square omega square. So that's why plus minus omega is written here. Now, after that, we can learn the cases also. At mean, x is equal to 0. Or first we write at extreme. At extreme, x is equal to a. If I substitute x is equal to a, sorry, here we use capital A because for amplitude we use capital A. So x is equal to capital A. Now instead of this x, I substitute capital A. Then capital A square minus capital A square, 0. So v is coming 0. So that we already written here. So x is a, then v is equal to 0. Now case 2. At mean position, x is equal to 0. As you substitute x is equal to 0, then this term get cancelled. And we get a formula of v plus minus omega in a root a square. Root a square means a. So v is equal to plus minus a omega. And this is